reach, receive, disciple, and send. This is the mission of Christ Church United Methodist, and this is our last installment on the Growing as Community short series. What I wanted to highlight today was those first Easter Christian communities, and I wanted to share with you that they looked a lot like what we are looking like right now as Christians around this world. Because you see, after Easter, after the Ascension, you can turn into the book of Acts and you can find the disciples gathering into homes, into small rooms around, and you can see them waiting and praying together. But I also want to share with you a specific story, two actually. The first story I wanted to share is when they are waiting for the Holy Spirit, when they're waiting for the Spirit to lead them to that next step and their faith journey, they don't just sit there passively waiting. Wesley calls it active waiting, which you do everything you can to ready yourself and get ready for whatever God is going to launch you into. And you do it by attending to prayer, to growing in the scriptures, to continue to grow in love and compassion and service to your neighbors. And so the first disciples gather in an upper room, and there are 120 of them. And they are doing everything they can to support one another as they wait for that gift of the Spirit to come down over them. Now, I've been in these rooms. They don't fit 120 people at once. And so what I want you to hear is that these were gatherings that added together would equal 120. But it's not just about the waiting for the Spirit, because something awesome happens when the Spirit comes. The church is born. No longer are we just followers. We are the church, the body of Christ. We are now gifted with the Spirit to live and love as Christ lived and loved for us. And so as the church of believers, they gather around. They gather in small homes. They gather in small groups. They pray together. They grow together. They love and share everything they have to make sure that all of them come through this, that all of them are ready and going for the next step. Because they don't know where the Spirit's leading them. Nothing like this has ever happened to them before. And how they respond changes the world. They respond with love, with service, and with trust in their Lord Jesus the Christ. And so I just invite you to receive the words of our pastor, Jay Parkins. Tomorrow on Sunday, do it with an open heart and ask for God's word to be taught through him, through the scripture, and especially through the Acts of the Apostles and our Lord Jesus the Christ. Now let us go and serve as a community of faith, hope, and love. God bless.